There's so many voices though. How did they coordinate all this? There's like four people I can hear. Five. It's insane. How many cameras did they use for this?
Good morning, everyone. It's Tony. So today marks the final tipping point, the capping off point for NCT 2020's Resonance Project, this time being an inclusion of all 23 members. That's right there, including the entire NCT universe, Wavy, NCT Dream, as well as NCT 127. All of these members are coming together for this special brand new single, which I think we all saw coming, being titled Resonance. This was hinted at their previous NCTU's video being titled Work It. It is essentially like the big boss, the final boss, the final stage, a huge just like crazy stage. And if you couldn't tell already from this picture, it's gonna look really daunting, very badass. And from these teasers, I am so excited. That's a lot of visuals, a lot of talent, and just a lot of just fire that's about to happen, I think, from this video. So I'm super excited for it, and you can definitely bet that I'm assuming this is gonna be the biggest bump of them all. But with that being said, if you also want to go check out any of my other NCT reactions throughout this entire Resonance project, whether it be NCTU's 90s Love, From Home, Make a Wish, Misfit, Kick It from 127, Wavy's Battle Live or Turn Back Time, or anything else, including Work It from NCTU as well, I'll leave it all linked in the description box down below for you guys. Hopefully you do check out a video after this. But with that being said, let us not waste any more time and let's get into the fire that is going to be NCT 2020's Resonance. Jinbi, ready? She check. Alrighty, so SM finally released it, so I'm very hyped, but at the same time, SM, why you gotta keep on doing this to us? I was so hyped, and then I saw that, and I was like really kind of actually let down, but without being said, let's get into it. Hey yo, listen up, no matter what you say, no matter what they do, we're gonna resonate, mark in the middle. Jeez! Yo, I honestly thought for a second my thing was like messing up. It's cool. I like the aspect of like having it laggy a bit. It kind of feels like it's really resonating, and at the same time it makes you like question, it's like, is my connection bad? Is it just the video? It's actually the video itself. It's really cool, and they're panning through every single member. All 23 of them. Oh, Lucas! Tay? Okay, Tay? Wow, that was very smooth, and I am very impressed with the opening so far. It transitioned from this like kind of very hyped up to like continuing the hype, but with like a kind of like Middle Eastern kind of accent here. It's really cool. Ooh, we have the whistling too. Wow, their voices are really cool. It's really kind of like raspy, but at the same time that makes a cool kind of like contrast with like the smooth whistling that we heard and the smooth voices that just happened. That's a really nice transition. Oh, smooth voices! Right. Ooh, hello. All 23 of them, that's insane. But on top of it all, it has this kind of still at the same time Middle Eastern exotic flair to it, but it's less, I would say, kind of like Middle Eastern Asian, and kind of did more kind of just Middle Eastern like Moroccan style now with this like more guitar-esque type of sound. Ooh. Wow. Could you imagine how they have- There's a lot of- oh my god, so much to like look at. That was smooth. That was nice. Oh. It's like more street vibe. Western. Boop, boop, boop.
time mark. It's kind of like almost coming back to 90s love, the vibe from that. Actually, it could be. Like, actually, now that I think of it, it kind of feels like they're going through actually all the songs that that the Resonance album had. So the first one's kind of like a callback to like Make-A-Wish, where it was like that exotic flair. And now this one's kind of like a call to 90s love a bit with that Western influence, kind of like hip-hop beat. Maybe a bit of a callback to Work It also. Oh, it is 10? I think, yeah. Lucas. Let's go, Lucas. Oh, it's from Work. Okay. Oh. Okay, so it's certainly really nice, this chorus. This chorus has like these cool kind of like exotic chords, as I've been mentioning, but I think at the same time they've been kind of like, in a sense, really doing like the idea of Resonate by kind of like reflecting these beats that they've incorporated in their other NCTU kind of like releases, being it like the Western style hip-hop beat that we got from like 90s love or like Work It, and then also including these like kind of Middle Eastern exotic flares that we got in like Make-A-Wish and other parts of their actual song. There's so many voices though. How did they coordinate all this? Could you imagine having to coordinate this? There's so many moving parts. The roof. Ooh, sexy part. 10, okay. Ooh. This is more of a modern type of beat, I would say. Damn. But I still like retro beat. The bass in this part. I think it really is calling back to it, because in Work It in particular, they do that like part. It's like skirt skirt. And it, actually, I think these are all, I think they're actually going through the set of groups, the NCTU groups that did each part of the song, because the chorus has all of them. But then when we're looking at the each individual section, it's like each individual member that was part of the group that did the certain song, this one being for Work It. So I think that's kind of like a callback, and that is kind of like bringing that back idea of like Resonate, kind of like Resonate the songs that they've been performing. And it does have a similar style, because when you think about it, this person in the back, this member, I don't actually know all their names, kind of did have like this more emotional portion in Work It. So I think it's like very much a reference to that, because you have the same members doing the vocals, I think. Skirt, skirt. Oh, he literally said, yeah, there we go. So we really did go through all of them, and then the spin effect too, just like in Work It. And here's the dance break. Jeez. All right, Mark. All right, everyone. Oh, here's 10 spin part. Oh, yes. I like it. The after effects are kind of like techno-y, dancey vibes. It's kind of like futuristic, retro-esque at the same time, like the turning of the radio. It's really cool. I can't believe they had a wide enough camera lens to capture all these people. Okay. Wow, there are some solid vocals that I have never heard, because I think that a lot of them are from... I have not heard them. Wow. Those high notes were great. There's so many people stacked on top of one another, and the fact that they harmonized them is insane. Yeah. Let's go! There's like four people I can hear. Five. It's insane. It's the boom. And I'm drunk. Okay, yo, my man who is doing these high notes at the end, I specifically know who it is. I don't know their name, but it's this man absolutely killing it. Going high note to high note to higher, higher note is absolutely insane. Boof. Yeah. Oh, actually, it's different voices now that I'm listening to it. This is insane. The resonate. How many cameras did they use for this? I feel like I'm in a stadium. What in the world? That was insane. I'm actually just so blown away by the fact that they managed to capture so many members. Like 23 members in a full frame is crazy enough, let alone the fact that they made it pan and everything. So like, video aesthetics aside, the song itself is super fun because it does play on that idea of like the resonate aspect again, kind of like going through all the big songs that they've released and having kind of like those specific NCTU members in that portion of the video. So you had like, particularly I could make out for, I like 90s Love, Work It, and then also Make a Wish. And obviously there probably are a few other kind of call outs and callbacks to songs that they've released in this like whole resonance project of theirs. It's a very kind of like fun idea because I liked the familiarity that I heard, but at the same time it sounded very new because it was put up in a way that wasn't kind of like sounding familiar and kind of like in the same order that we heard. So I like that, and I like how the chorus also changes through it, taking aspects of each portion and kind of like influencing them. So in the first chorus, I think we had like that Make-A-Wish section, so it brought in that kind of like Middle Eastern vibe in the background for the chorus. But then when we go to like say Work It, which is kind of like a more kind of like retro-y kind of funky beat, that funky beat got brought into the chorus also instead of kind of like the exotic strings that we heard in the first chorus. So that's a really cool little like small detail, and they've always just kept on improving the vocals. The vocals at the finisher though were absolutely insane. I was so amazed. That was so good, and I am so looking forward to what is next, whether it be NCT 127, NCT Dream, Wave V, all of these things. I'm so excited to see what these guys come up with next, and hopefully you guys are too. So hopefully you guys do stay tuned, and in the meantime, if you want to go check out any of my other NCT reactions, I'll leave them all linked in the description box below, as I mentioned. Hopefully you guys do check them out. But with that being said, guys, thank you so much for watching. 감사합니다. And as always, if you have any comments, questions, or something you want to talk, feel free to leave in the comments section below, and I'll get to it as soon as possible. With that being said, guys, it's been Tony. I know he can say, oh, goodbye, and I'll see you in the next video. I'm about to raise your-